It's about that time of day again. Welcome to your nightly newsletter, boys and girls. Joseph James here. Tuesday evening, April 28, 2015. In tonight's newsletter, crude oil is right smack in the middle of its range ahead of tomorrow's big news. We get FOMC and the inventory report tomorrow for crude oil. Try to jam a little bit more into that day tomorrow for crude. But we look a little bit closer at the price action chart, and we see a very clear set of clues on the black gold. We get a bearish trend, and we have a trading range going into Wednesday. Crude oil traders, you want to stick around for this report this evening. How about gold? Well, there must be an FOMC report around the corner, because the yellow metal has been jumpy, pushed even higher today. We talked about the spike in channel we got yesterday. Get another spike in channel in the session today, thanks to the 10 o'clock news. Now, all the way up at the extreme highs of the trading range. We've been watching that range. Well, there's a price wedge, and there's a big round number on the gold chart. All of those clues are telling us, sellers, you guys want to be paying close attention if you're trying to get short before the FOMC meeting tomorrow. Guys, we have a very important pre-FOMC newsletter for you guys and gals tonight. Before we begin, please remember, everything I'm covering tonight's video, I teach to all of our students every day here at schooloftrade.com. We get a great free trial, a great free pass to attend our trade room. And before we jump into our charts this evening, I want to remind you, it's very important that you watch this video on our trading blog. In addition to all the other great resources on this trading blog, I want to remind you guys, make sure you're watching this video over at sidewaysmarkets.com. Below the video tonight, you can download all my charts. Upper left-hand corner, you can grab a free pass to attend our live trade room as a guest. And, of course, we have a nightly newsletter mailing list in the lower right-hand corner. All I need is your name and your email address, and I'll send you an email every evening when the newsletter goes live. Just be aware, if you grab your free pass or you register for the mailing list, the newsletter mailing list, I'm going to send you a verification email. So make sure you check your inbox to make sure you find that verification email. And if you have any questions along the way, we've always got someone standing by here to help you guys out. All right? Don't forget, download those charts. Have them ready for tomorrow. Ready to rock and roll? Let's start here first this evening with the yellow metal. Gold, jumpy. Came back to 1,200 and then see ya all the way up to the highs. Now, I drew this trend line in here, obviously, this evening, right? But we had this red box of resistance here from last night's newsletter. So all the way up to the secondary, we had one more. We had a level there, of course, before, right? So now we're all the way up almost to the extreme highs of that range. Not much has changed here on the gold, right? So here we are trading up at the range highs this evening. Our plan is really the same, is to sell the highs and buy the lows of this trading range. With tomorrow being FOMC, usually what happens is the markets like gold, they'll kind of take shelter around big round numbers ahead of those major news events. So it wouldn't surprise me at all before we finish the morning tomorrow, we end right back at 1,200 ahead of that 2 p.m. Eastern time, right, news report. Okay, possibly even a little bit further down to this 1194.5, right? Wouldn't be surprised at all if it collapses off these highs and then finds a way to kind of settle in here around that 1,200. Put it this way, I'll be really surprised tomorrow if this news comes out at 2 o'clock and we're not somewhere within that 1,200, you know, a couple dollars, give or take, above or below, ahead of that FOMC news report tomorrow. Just the way gold tends to act. Now, remember, FOMC, 8 times a year, you know the drill, right? I'll put the link below the video if you want to learn more about FOMC and what it's all about. But we know, though, that most of the time, these markets are going to be pretty much flat ahead of that news. And gold is always historically the one that's affected the most by it. So careful trading gold tomorrow. If there's one market I would definitely be careful, it's this market. Another market would be something that is currency-based, like the euro, right? We don't really trade the dollar index, but the euro would be a good example, right? That'll be another market that'll be pretty jumpy. It'll be almost flatlined ahead of the news, and then, of course, it'll be very volatile afterwards just because of the nature of the FOMC meeting and monetary policy tomorrow. Don't forget, we'll be trading that tomorrow in our trade room, so come out and join us if you need any help. So sellers right now, really kind of setting the stage here right now. Sellers, you've got the green light. All you need is the trigger, right? So reversal pattern off the high. That's one way to get into it, right? Reversal pattern off the high. Failed buying pattern off the high, right? Or wait for it to come on down and, right, sell those rips on the way down to that 1200, right? Whatever you need to use as your entry trigger. We've got a set of entry triggers here at School of Trade. I'll teach them all to you guys as students, but we're trying to get down to that 1200. If they keep on pushing, this has been a relatively, like I said before, jumpy market. If we keep on pushing, we'll definitely look for another swing at the highs, right? Until we get out of this range, you've got to keep fading these moves, right? It's the best strategy to use, right? So up to the highs, fade it back in. Up to the highs, bull trap, fade it back in. Now, again, because the FOMC is such a dramatic news event tomorrow, I'm kind of planning for the bigger moves here, right? So what if it just jumps all the way up, right? Fade that too. Okay, see where I'm going with this? So if it does get crazy tomorrow after the FOMC report, you want to have a couple levels outside of that range just to make sure you're ready for it, right? We go lower, fade it back up. Lower, fade it back up. Lower, I don't think we go all the way down to 55 tomorrow, right? Fade it back up. So until something changes, until this market tells us that we have found a true direction, we'll continue to follow our plan, which has worked very, very well here so far, right, on the gold, okay? You guys know the plan tomorrow here on the gold for the anchor chart. Now, this is a 2 days in a row of some really just jumpy, right? Just kind of jumpy price action here out of gold. So we got three clues on the gold price action chart. Here's a tick chart now of gold. A little bit different look at it. Much closer now, right? We've now zoomed way in on this chart right now. And you can see it on the bottom here. I tried to split this up as best I could. There's a lot to talk about on this chart. We have three big clues for tomorrow. First, the larger channel. Larger bull channel. You can see that larger bull channel. Okay, so the bull channel gives us really the ultimate direction right now. This is a bullish market, right? Whether we like it or not, we get a definite bigger picture look and we can see where we are in this bullish market all the way up at the highs. So sellers here, stay tuned here for more. You're going to want to know more about where you can find opportunities here to get short. So knowing that we're in a bullish market, we know if you're a buyer right now on the gold, your sweet spot is going to be down around, right, that channel low. That's really where you want to be looking to be a buyer if you're a bull here on the yellow metal. First things first, long-term bull channel tells us we have a kind of a medium-term bullish trend, right? We looked at the long term on the other chart, and we definitely are range bound that longer term. So, second, a trading range. This trading range, right? You might have been wondering, where did we go to, right? Where were we jumping higher to today? Well, you take that double top in price, double bottom in price. There's a little bit more over on the left-hand side you can't see. We take that, copy and paste, right? There's your range expansion, and you can see it's just very easy to see here. That is just a one-time range expansion. Now, again, because tomorrow's FOMC, I want to give you a couple more levels overhead here so you are prepared for tomorrow, right? So we got another range expansion resistance on there as well. And the third clue we see here is the spike in channel. Right? The third clue we see here is that spike in channel. I know, another spike in channel. We went through this yesterday too, and we were talking about that that battle zone, which we actually never even made it even close. The battle zone was down around this 1196 area, never even made it close. That was your dead giveaway today, that gold wasn't even thinking about going lower, right? It didn't even make it down into that battle zone, which we talked about last night in the newsletter. Remember, when things that usually happen do not happen, they're not that important, but we look for more evidence, right? We look for more clues. So it's somewhat significant when what should have happened didn't happen. But as I always remind our clients here at School of Trade, we're paid to anticipate, but we always need proof. So the fact that we didn't push lower, right? Remember that battle zone we talked about from last night? The fact that we didn't get down into that battle zone, That's a huge bullish clue. Then you need to get proof, though, right? Then you need to get proof. Remember how I always say, look for people to fail twice, right? They try once, they try twice, and then whoop, right up, right? And then, of course, 10 o'clock news came in, and it was just sayonara. It took off to the upside. So one long-term bull channel. That tells us buyers, be ready here to buy these lows, okay? Be ready to buy the low of this channel, okay? Second, the trading range. The trading range actually gives us quite a bit of useful information, especially this range expansion area overhead, which is going to line up with that third clue, which is the spike in channel, right? Take out the spike. There's a spike. There's the channel. You know, spike in channels, when they succeed, they make for measured moves. And so that's also a measured move. All the way up, just happens to conveniently be placed at that range expansion resistance. So here's my scenarios. We got really three options here for us tomorrow. Let's say three options for us tomorrow. Okay, so the trend is bullish this evening. The buyers will wait to buy the lows of the long-term channel. Okay, or wait for new higher highs for that run up to 2177. Sellers, you guys have a short-term opportunity right now, right, to get down to those channel lows and then a possible failure back to that big round number. So here are the three scenarios that I see us getting right now. Okay, first of all, the buyers take this. Buyers take it. They continue to push it higher. Breakout pullback above the range expansion resistance, right? Don't buy the high, but wait to buy the pullback, and you're off of the races. You get an easy, easy target up there at 21.7. Second scenario, we come down to those lows, we hold the lows, and we take back off, retest the high of that channel, right? Remember, the channel goes low to high to low, right? So we rotate down to lows, the buyers pick up on it, right? And we go back to the highs. Here's scenario number three. We still go down to those lows, but now instead of rotating back to the highs, the buyers try once, buyers twice, right? And they fail, and we tumble back to that 1,200 big round number. Maybe we even go even lower, right? Maybe the sellers are really strong tomorrow. Maybe it's a very rosy FOMC report that we get tomorrow afternoon, 1191.3. There's another useful tidbit from this range expansion, right? Remember, I told you the range is actually pretty useful on this chart. It gives you some great targets above us, and it also explains a little bit more about that spike in channel. Okay, so bulls. If you're a bull right now, stay patient here on the gold. You're either waiting for a clear new higher high and a pullback, or you're waiting, if price goes lower here and you're a bull, you're waiting for that turn at that channel low. If you're a bear right now, I would definitely look for clues that this midline has been broken, a significant closed candle below that midline, and then sell those retracements down to those channel lows as support. Be careful selling those channel lows. And then again, I'd wait for the buyers once, twice, and when they fail, taking it short down to 1,200, possibly down to that 91.33. We'll have to see how this news comes out tomorrow. Be ready for anything, and do not be surprised. Like I said, do not be surprised if this gold is asleep tomorrow ahead of that news. Usually what happens is we're going to get a couple hours. You know, you'll get the whole London session, obviously. But here in the U.S., though, you'll get those first, you know, 7 to 10, 7 to 10:30, and then it's going to be dead asleep until we get that 2 o'clock report, all right? Traders will go to lunch early, they'll come back early, and they'll be there to watch the report tomorrow. Gold's a little bit challenging, okay? We're gonna make it a little bit easier on us for crude. Yuck! Right back into the range here again. Pretty much got what we expected from last night's newsletter. Now here we are, again, we keep fading those lows, right? Fade the lows, fade the lows, fade the highs, fade the lows. Once again, we're going to continue here. Price goes up, sell it back down. Price goes down, bring it right back up. Same scenario here as we saw on the gold, right? So we're right smack in the middle of the range. Not a big surprise considering the fact that we got FOMC tomorrow. We have inventories tomorrow, right? And besides this complete hogwash about this, you know, this captured ship. Are you kidding me? Oh, what I meant to say was it was a Navy. Are you kidding me? Talk about media trying to stir the pot today. What a joke. It made for a good laugh or two in our trade room today. But if you happen to read what actually happened today out there and on the news wires, I couldn't tell if it was purposely manipulated by the news media. Oh, come on, Joe. Are you kidding me? Of course it was purposely manipulated. Nothing is left to be just as it comes out. But it was, besides that little snafu and the shenanigans on the news wire this morning around 10 o'clock, it was a pretty uneventful day. Tomorrow we have inventories. Tomorrow we have FOMC. This is exactly what I would expect ahead of two big news reports like we're having tomorrow. Okay, only thing that make it even more interesting is if tomorrow was rollover, which it's not, thank goodness, right? Well, at least we have to worry about rollover tomorrow. Our plan remains the same. Sell the highs, buy the lows, and stay patient in the middle. The hardest part of our job right now for you crudesters out there is just staying the heck out of this area in the middle, right? Wait for this price to get down to those lows, buy it back up. Wait for it to break out, right? Wait for the sellers to try, fail, and right back up. Wait for it to go up, right? And then right back down. It's exactly what we've been doing for the past 2 weeks here on crude. This is not going to last forever, right? But while it's doing this for us, we are going to take advantage of it. So stick to the plan. Be prepared tomorrow for a decent reaction. We got big news. Okay, so be prepared, but don't forget about the plan. Don't get wrapped up in the short-term move tomorrow. Keep this chart right off to the side. Keep this in the back of your mind. Don't get wrapped up on fake out, breakout, trap, right, bull trap, bear traps, the highs and lows. Okay, so we want to make sure you're prepared. Add a little bit more resistance overhead. Add a few levels of support below. Now you know if we really bust out of this little wedge we're seeing here right now, if we really make a run for it, you know where to look to fade those moves. Very, very rarely does the initial reaction to the inventory reports and the FOMC lead to long-term movement. Okay, tomorrow we'll be looking at the long-term movement after FOMC. So expect the fake-out breakouts, right? We'll be trading this in real time tomorrow in our trade room. We'll be watching and seeing exactly what happens. So come out and join me. How about the price action chart here of crude? Wrapping up here with another tick chart, the 2400 tick on crude oil futures. This is giving us a lot more information to use. It's not just smack in the middle of the range. We can definitely see, in my opinion, there are two significant clues here. The first clue, obviously, is that same bear channel. Remember this from last night? In last night's newsletter, we talked about the fact that we hadn't confirmed the channel yet. Oh, now we have. Now we have four total tests with two on each side. A confirmed channel, four total tests, two on each side, right? Just kind of common sense. What I like to see on top of that is a 45-degree angle. We don't quite have a 45-degree angle, but this is a long-term channel. And as I was saying today in the room, you just don't usually see 45-degree angles on longer-term, you know, multi-day, multi-week channels. They're usually closer to about half of that, right? About 20 to 30% degrees as far as the slope goes of the channel. That's the first thing. So we definitely see the lower highs. We definitely see the lower lows. In fact, on that channel, we actually saw a channel break. So the buyers had their shot, and now the sellers, they couldn't keep up the moving average. They tried again to keep above the moving average, couldn't keep it. At this point, it looks like we are destined to get back to those lows at $56 a barrel. Pretty much what we talked about last night, right? Pretty much exactly what we talked about last night. It's just taking its sweet old time, right? Like molasses trying to get down here right now. So pretty much what we expected, right? We got the undershoot. We were expecting to get an overshoot. We got the overshoot. Now we're expecting to get that price to retest those lows. Next thing here, trading range. This trading range gives us a great set of targets to the downside, 55.21. It gives us a great resistance level overhead. Hey, this is crude we're talking about, right? I'm at 57 right now. 59 and a quarter is not that big of a deal tomorrow during FOMC and inventory. So be ready for expansion of this range if it happens up that way. So again, the trading range definitely tells us here, and then you'll notice we have an undershoot of the highs of that range. So we're definitely seeing bearishness right now. We're definitely seeing weakness of the highs. We're seeing weakness from those bulls. Not quite sure if it's strength in sellers just yet, but I hate to use the term, but the bulls felt like a bunch of sissies today. They really did. We were watching it the whole time, and I'm going, this is all you got? Really? It just, the feel of the price action made it very clear the bulls made a run for it. We looked at the bigger picture, this chart today, and we said, oh, well, it's very clear why these bulls, you know, they kind of flirted around with it, right? The news of the cargo ship hit. It goes up to the highs. You could easily see as the truth came out, kind of the air got let out of those bull balloons, right? And it came right back down. It was really amazing to see that the price action analysis that we use, regardless of the news that came out today, it makes you think, what comes first, right? The technicals or the fundamentals? What comes first? Was it the rumors of the cargo ship today that pushed price higher? Or was it the overshoot that we saw last night, right? See how it all, it's amazing, this world we live in of technical analysis. Isn't it crazy? It's one big symphony orchestra, and every single instrument is in a different location, and there's no conductor. I mean, it really is remarkable. It really, as far as I'm concerned, it really makes me believe in this crowd psychology, this self-fulfilling prophecy, everything that we teach here at School of Trade. It really is fascinating stuff when you think about it, right? Was it because of the airship, or the cargo ship, or was it because of the analysis that was there 24 hours ago, right? It didn't take the cargo ship to know this. We knew this going into it. Why? Because we read the price action leading up to it. There's never going to be a linear cause and effect. There's never going to be a time where we can place emphasis on one specific event and say that caused this. Right? We are all a byproduct. This market is a byproduct of every tick of this market ever since its inception. It's remarkable when you think about it. And it's pretty cool to think that from our home offices, from our laptops, and soon someday be from our mobile phones and from our tablet PCs, we can do all this anywhere in the world. It's pretty remarkable when you think about it. What a great business it is to be in. So, off my soapbox now. I tell you, this is the reason why I do this. I find it absolutely fascinating. And I tell this to my clients all day long, if this stuff doesn't get your heart racing a little bit, I don't want to say in the wrong business, but you're definitely in the wrong trade room, right? Because this stuff is pretty darn cool. Anyways, trading range gives us good structure. The channel tells us stick to the downside. How about some targets here? Well, the fact that those bulls failed to get those buyers engaged up top here definitely tells me we're gunning for that low again. We're gunning for that low. You got a measured move target down here. Right, these are very symmetrical moves going lower. I got my eyes all over this 56. All right, 56 is definitely just screaming at us to be a short-term target. So I would imagine we go higher. I'm looking for more selling opportunities. We go lower, more selling opportunities. Again, that's the plan. Very, very simple and very similar. We've done what we've pretty much been doing all week. Keep selling those highs on crude. Be looking for the buyers to fail at the highs, right? Remember, there's two ways to get short, right? Two ways to get short. I can look for a selling pattern, right? A selling setup or a failed buying setup. And it's always a great spot to look for failed buyers up around the highs, right? It's always a great spot to look for failed buyers down at the lows. Okay, top of the range, bottom of the range. That's where you're going to find those buyers coming in, and that's where they, if they fail, they rush out of those trades. You're going to get great opportunities here to keep it going lower. All right, guys, I have a plan for tomorrow. Make sure you follow the plan for tomorrow. And remember, guys, you're not alone out there. Come out and see me tomorrow in the trade room. We open up 8 a.m. Eastern time, Monday through Friday. And, of course, I plan on coming back and doing one more of these with you guys tomorrow, too. Same time, same place. Shall we do it again in the manana? Have a great FOMC. Have a great inventory day. Remember, inventories, 10 o'clock tomorrow. Careful after 10 o'clock tomorrow. Careful after 10 a.m. tomorrow. Don't forget, download those charts. There they go, right below the video. Download charts, grab your free pass, register for the newsletter list. And while I got your attention, join that free trial for 1 week. You're going to learn more with me for 1 week than you will anywhere else on these interwebs. I got a free pass for you to come out and join our trade room in the afternoon, and I look forward to answering all your questions here, whether you're a member or a guest here at School of Trade. I will see you guys tomorrow. My name is JJ. Thanks for being here. Be well. Be nice to each other. And try to get out of the office. I'm sure it's beautiful weather out there. That ocean is calling me here in Los Angeles. I'll see you guys in the mañana.